do what? Apply what?
Pressure.
See what's in you. When pressure is applied to it, the real you is going to come. Oh, y'all preaching with me now. The pressure, sometimes the sweet part of you is still on the inside, and you've been fooling with the wrong folk that's been wrestling with the hard part of you. Preach, Zachary. That's how it is with me. You've been fooling around with folk with men and women that's only dealing with the outside.
That's right.
Come on now. But if you get with the right person, Sister Ingram, that can challenge you and dig deeper to the inside, the sweet side, and really apply the necessary pressure, then your juices will flow. Now we're able. Because of the pressure that was applied to you. You had never been under pressure, you would have never known you could handle it. Some of you have been through stuff that the average person would have committed suicide. The average person would have given up, would have left their marriage, would have left their home, would have left their children.
Come on, come on.
But you went through it and you survived it. Yeah. And you're a survivor. High five three people and say, I'm a survivor, baby.
I'm
I can survive it. I'm a survivor. I'm gonna make it. I ain't gonna give up. Because there's something sweeter on the inside. And something on the inside, Prince Zachary, is gonna work on the outside. And all will change. But I got to get a little pressure. And I need somebody to squeeze me a little bit. Watch it. Stop being mad before talking about you. Stop being mad before they invite you to their little Christmas party. Stop being mad when they don't invite you over Thanksgiving. They ain't doing nothing but squeezing you. You got to learn how to make your drink and drink it too. If they don't invite me to the next party, so what? I can have my own party. I can sing my own show. It's my party, and I cry if I want to. It's my party. I can smack up in that group. That squeeze was a little darker than the first squeeze. And gentlemen,
the pressure caused him to turn his back on God. But I had Job saying Psalm 13 and 15. He said, though he strengthened, yet will I trust in it. But I will maintain my always. Say for the Lord, why don't you wave your hand and say amen. Listen, he'll jump to your feet real quick. While y'all are struggling, they jump to your feet. Encourage your neighbor. Find somebody close to you that looks like they glad to take the church. And looks like that the pressure is going to turn into their praise. Grab their hand. Shake their hand. Shake their hand and rock them. And then rock them and shake them. And tell them these words. Tell them to neighbor. Let your pressure produce your praise. Say, neighbor, let your problems produce your power. Say, neighbor, let your failures produce your future. Let your struggles produce your strength. Let your turmoil produce your triumph. Let your sorrows produce your success. Let your pity produce your patience. Let your junk produce your joy. Let your loss produce your love. Let your pain to teach your peace. And when it's all said and done, we can say, like Psalm 150, the Bible declares, praise you, the Lord. Praise him in his sanctuary. Praise him in the firmament of his power. And stand in peace, oh Lord. And at the end, it says that we